Welcome back to Cooking with E. Today, we're going to be making some country ribs. Stay tuned. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. I really appreciate the support. Today we're doing some country ribs. This is a kind of a forgotten meat in a lot of cases. People forget that you don't have to buy the full rack with all the bones and everything. You can buy country style ribs and have yourself a heck of a good pork meal without having to deal with the bones and some of the stuff, the pulling off the silver skin, some of the things you get with like a St. Louis style rib. This is pretty cheap too. I think I paid $6 or $7 for this whole pack, and that's quite a bit of meat. So today we're going to be using the Luton Booty Spice and my own little concoction here. This is salt, pepper, garlic, a little bit of fruit punch Kool-Aid, just a packet just shook in there, and brown sugar. I did a pork butt with it the other day, and oh my goodness, it is amazing, and it adds such a really good deep red color. Something about fruit and pork, they just go together. So I have the Traeger, the rebuilt Traeger. It's on smoke right now, just got it turned on, it's warmed up. I'm gonna go ahead and get these put on, and I'm gonna let these things smoke for 1 hour. So all right, let's prep these things. So we're gonna take the secret sauce here, my secret rib, E's special magic. Pop that on there. And you never, ever, ever under season these. Always season the heck out of them. They handle seasoning very, very, very well. All right. Now I like to take and kind of dap it in a little bit like that. A little dap, 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 dap. See, you can already see that red. That red coloring coming in from that fruit punch. Yes, it's a secret, but y'all can try it, see what you think. Please let me know in the comments below, what are some of the crazy things you guys have tried that is has worked out well? Yeah, look at that. It's almost looking like a steak. So flip that over. Yeah, see the stark difference in contrast there? Let's go ahead and flip this bad boys. Bad boy. And sorry. There we go. And one more. Get this side seasoned up. And we can get these babies chucked on there. And I'll cook them fat side up. The other thing I wanted to mention on country ribs, I know some people probably have a bad experience or have had, you know, chewy or what have you. Always look for the fatty ones. Look for the ones that are marbled like a good steak. Those are the ones you want because that fat just turns into love, or as I call it, pork butter. And man, it just really, really lights your palate on fire. All the good super juice. All right, here we go. Excuse me. Oh, there we are. Try and get this done. One-handed. There we go. Make sure I got the fat up. There's the fat. This side here is fat up. Okay, fat up. This one didn't really have much fat on the top side, but let's get her up like that. This one here, okay. Fat up. There we go. I'm gonna let these things smoke for an hour. I'm gonna kick it on to 300 after that hour, and I'm gonna wrap them and cook them for another 2 hours at 300. Time to get these things wrapped. Oh, and I couldn't find any mango or anything like that, so I'm just going to use a little bit of this. When I wrap them, I'll put this in there as my braising liquid or whatever the heck you want to call it in the bottom of the tinfoil, just to keep nice and moist a little. Got a storm coming. Gotta get these ribs done. Ow, come on. Don't you love it?
always remember, the side that is not shiny is the nonstick. Side up. So I had them on smoke for 1 hour. I'm wrapping them. I'm gonna put the grill to 300. Keep them fat side up. Put a little liquid in there. Wrap them. We got 2 more hours left. Make sure you seal them up real good, okay?
Here we go. It's been 3 hours.
Got some storm clouds.
But it held off enough for us to get these things done. Let's pull them. We're gonna let them sit for about, at least a half hour. All right. Here we go. There's some juice in there. If you notice, there's no steam coming out, which means I definitely got them wrapped good. So, all right, I'm gonna let these things sit and we will unveil our final product. Moment of the truth. Let's see what happened. These have been sitting for about 15, 20 minutes or so. Hopefully my second piece of foil kept all that love in there. By the way, when you're opening this stuff, unless you want a facial, keep your head back. Oh my goodness. Oh. Can you hand me a fork, please? Oh, let's see. Are they tender? Yeah, I would say they're tender. All right, let's go ahead and try these out. Oh, just look at that. How juicy. They're so tender. They just fall apart. Don't ever forget about country ribs. I know everybody buys normal ribs, but man, you're missing out. They're real cheap. All right, let me try this out.
I'm telling you, they're so tender, juicy. Please do yourself a favor. Don't forget about this meat. It's real cheap, real easy. If you cook it right, it's amazing. I appreciate the support. Click that subscribe button. I'll see you on the next one. I appreciate you.